It's winter in Singapore, but we're about to turn up the heat inside the Singapore Indoor Stadium. We are less than 24 hours away from one Winter Warriors. Michael Chiavello, the Dragon, Mitch Chilson with you. Dragon, you can feel the heat in here already because tomorrow night is going to be epic with an amazing card, including a double main event with championship gold on the line in both those contests. Regian Eersel defends the lightweight kickboxing world title against Islam Murtazaev, and of course the much anticipated Stamp versus Ritu in the Atomweight World Grand Prix Championship Final.
Oh, but look at that lightweight matchup as top five contenders rematch, and are they gonna put on a show?
And check this out, folks. We are broadcast to over 150 countries. We are on the air everywhere tomorrow night. Join us in India, Japan, Indonesia, Thailand, the USA, the Philippines, and beyond. Dragon, I'm super excited for those two main events. We've also got Timofey Nastyukhin versus Dagi. Arslanaliev could be the show stealer. And also Kang Ji Won and Buchecha may not go the distance. But let's go now to Dom Lau to begin our weigh-ins for one Winter's Warriors.
Facing off first in a one flyweight mixed martial arts contest from Japan, Yuya, Little Piranha, Wakamatsu!
Japanese flag over the shoulder of the Little Piranha, Yuya Wakamatsu, in the flyweight contest against Yong of China. The old arch rivals, China and Japan, set to throw down in the opening contest tomorrow night.
61.2 kilos for Yuya Wakamatsu!
61.2 in a very risky contest for Wakamatsu. Should he lose tomorrow night, the chances of fighting Adriano Moraes, the champion, maybe go away. Big risk fight for Yuya Wakamatsu.
And his opponent, representing China, Wolf Warrior, Huyong!
The Wolf Warrior, Huyong of China, looking ripped. A big chance to upset Wakamatsu.
Making weight at 60.7 kilos, Huyong!
Dragon, how do you fancy Huyong's chances of defeating Wakamatsu? As I said, it would be considered an upset.
Well, we saw Huyong against Y2K, and he looked really sharp. He's racked up five straight finishes and victories inside one championship. He had a very successful career outside, but now he is stepping up to a whole different level against Yuya Wakamatsu.
Two very proud men. Look at that stare down. No blinking whatsoever between Huyong and Yuya Wakamatsu. Who's going to break gaze first here? Well, Rick Audi has to do it for them. Neither of those men were going to back down from a staring contest, Dragon.
Yeah, Yuya Wakamatsu spent time out there at Sanford MMA, and he believes he's put together a plan that can propel him in the flyweight division.
Okay, as I said, big risk fight for Yuya Wakamatsu. Should he lose to Huyong, that world title showdown against Adriano Moraes perhaps goes to the wayside. Dragon, it's going to be a heavyweight contest up next. And this is the one, folks, we do not think will go the distance tomorrow night. Kang Ji Won takes on Buchecha, a classic match of styles. The stand-up of Kang Ji Won, the ground of Buchecha.
Up next, in a one heavyweight mixed martial arts contest from Brazil, Buchecha!
Buchecha, tall, lean, powerful, one of the all-time BJJ greats.
117.45 kilos for Buchecha!
Just over 117 kilograms for Buchecha, the Brazilian, in his second mixed martial arts contest. 1-0 so far, but of course he comes off that decorated BJJ background.
And his opponent from South Korea, Mighty Warrior Kang Ji Won!
And so many people continue to underestimate this guy, but he's looking at going 6-0 tomorrow night and six finishes in a row.
111.8 kilos for Kang Ji Won!
So it gives up about 6 kilograms to Buchecha here, does Kang Ji Won, but he's got the power in the hands. You know what? Kang Ji Won's one of those guys, Dragon. If you walk past him on the street, you wouldn't think much to look at him. But my goodness, the power this guy wallops is intense. The way he handled Mehdi Bargi and Elliot Bari, he destroyed them.
Don't let that baby face fool you, Michael. That guy's a giant. You wouldn't be scared of that guy if you saw him in the street. He is huge, but he also moves like a middleweight. He's very fast, and that's what he needs to lean on. He needs to utilize that movement to stay away from Buchecha, because Buchecha is known for that double leg, and his ground game is a whole different level, ladies and gentlemen.
Listen, Dragon, let's be honest. If this goes to ground, if Buchecha gets it to ground, it's over, right?
I think it's pretty close to being a wrap, because we saw the way he was able to defend Mehdi Bargi when Kang Ji Won was on the ground. He did good there, but this is a different level of grappler.
Let's go back to Dom.
And now, in a one lightweight mixed martial arts contest from Turkey, Dagi Arslanaliev!
You talk about an absolute human wrecking ball, a machine, a finisher, the epitome of a finisher, and this guy is it, Dagi Arslanaliev.
76.65 kilos for Dagi Arslanaliev!
He knocked out Timofey Nastyukhin last time they fought in under 2 minutes. Will it be repeat or revenge for Timofey Nastyukhin?
And his opponent from Russia, Timofey Nastyukhin!
Let's see what sort of shape the nasty one is in. The jacket comes off. Is he going to peel the shirt off? I bet he's ripped. I bet he's stripped. I bet he's buffed. Come on, get on that scale. Give us a look there, Timofey. Oh, look at the size of the traps.
77.1 kilos for Mr. Nastyukhin. Oh,
my goodness, he's got muscles on top of muscles, Dragon. Nastyukhin looks in the best shape we've seen him in since he steamrolled Eddie Alvarez in Tokyo.
He looks like a ninja turtle, but I have been waiting for the return of Dagi for who knows how long. I cannot wait to see him back inside the circle. And it's up against Timofey. We get a rematch from one of the most exciting matches we've ever seen in one championship.
The size of Nastukin's biceps, they look like grapefruits are stuck under the skin. These two men know how to finish opponents. Take a look at these stats, folks. This is nuts, Dragon.
Yeah, look at that combined 86% finishing rate. There is no way this one's getting out of the first round. Nastyukhin's 6-second KO will live forever on highlight reels. And then Dagi's 25-second sub, whoo, this is gonna be fun.
I got goosebumps, Dragon. That one is my choice for the showstopper of the night tomorrow night. I say fight of the night, Nastyukhin Dagi.
Well, you guys gotta go back and you gotta watch the first match. And for the first 2 minutes of that fight, it was so much fun for as long as it lasted. Nastyukhin looked sharp, but then Dagi with that power, whoo, Michael, don't miss it.
Coming on stage now in a one bantamweight kickboxing contest from Japan, Hiroki Akimoto!
This guy came to one championship with so much hype, it got slightly derailed, but he's back on track, and this is a kid that can do damage.
65.25 kilos for Hiroki Akimoto!
65.25 kg for Hiroki Akimoto. That arch rivalry again here, Japan versus China. And wait till you see the next guy coming out, a new signing.
And now his opponent from China, the tank, Jianliang.
One of the most charismatic personalities to come out of China, the tank, Jianliang. Chinese flag draped over his shoulders. Such anticipation surrounding the one Super Series debut of the tank from China. Looks in good shape.
65.1 kilos for Jianliang.
Nice mean mug, closes the eyes, tilts the chin back. He's had an entire documentary crew following him around Singapore Dragon for the last week. He's a superstar in China.
Yeah, if you watch his highlight reel, you will know why. This guy is so explosive. The tank against Akimoto, this one is going to be some high-level striking, Michael.
Look at the intensity here from the tank. He could make Coffee nervous. And Akimoto not breaking gaze until Rick Hordy said, you've got to break gaze. What a stare down between these two. Another contender Dragon for the show stealer tomorrow night.
Yeah.
I can't wait to see the tank. And I know you're high on the tank.
I definitely agree, but I think the tank coming to one Super Series is going to be really interesting to watch because he's so dynamic, he's so explosive. It's going to be the straight linear attacks of Akimoto against those dynamic whirlwind type attacks coming from the tank.
Speaking of whirlwind, the next fight, these two have been on a collision course from day one. So many people thought they'd clash in the final. They are going to clash in the final when Stamp takes on Ritu Phogat. Born of Indian wrestling royalty, Ritu Phogat wants to make her name in the world of mixed martial arts.
मेरे परिवार के लिए नहीं पूरे मतलब पूरे हिंदुस्तान के लिए एक बहुत बहुत बड़ी बात होगी और बिल्कुल मतलब एक हिस्ट्री लिखी जाएगी
ตอนที่กรรมการชูมือว่าทั้งร้องไห้ทั้งกรี๊ดทั้งตื้นตันทั้งทุกอย่างรวมกันหมด
A Chinese boxing powerhouse versus an Indian wrestling powerhouse. There's the right hand again to the jaw. That stung Ritu Phogat. Can Mong Bo finish her?
I think Mong Bo thought she was going to get Ritu out of there. That's the heart of a warrior right there. What a turn of the tides.
Ritu Phogat domination.
Haraki kafi acha laga aur jo confidence level hai wo thoda sa up hua.
Lots of pressure coming from Stamp Fairtex.
Oh, the heavy knuckles from Stamp. She's done it. Stamp avenges her only loss in mixed martial arts. Ritu Phogat is only one step away from the one Atomweight World Grand Prix final. And here's the big slam from Ritu Phogat. A dominant display from the Indian Tigress. But who will she face in the final?
Stamp ka semi-final match dekha tha aur maine kafi kareeb se dekha tha.
That was a beautiful sweep by Stamp.
Stamp showing why she's the most dangerous striker in women's mixed martial arts as she struts into the final.
ถ้าไฟของลิตูนะคะหนูได้ศึกษาผู้ต่อยหนูคนนี้มาอย่างลึกซึ้งอยู่พอสมควรหนูมองลึกเข้าไปว่าหนูจะได้ต่อยกับลิตูแน่ๆค่ะ
มายังได้คุณว่าแชมเปี้ยนแกวมีเรียกอโพเนนต์แต่มีเรียกนิวเชลเลนจ์อุสเคเลียร์เรดิง
เขาอาจจะคิดว่าหนูกลัวเขาแต่หนูก็ไม่ใช่ไก่ลองบ่อนซะทีเดียว
จะมี wrestling เนี่ยจะมีแม่บ่ที่คําเด็กในก็มี
เขาไม่ดีคางเขาเปาะใช้มวยไทยของเราน็อกเอาท์เขาค่ะ
คุณแม่ยังแค่น่าจงกี้คือคุยบัตรนี้วิสติดไปด้านเดียวเลยแม่บิลคุลสบิโกสกครในวันนี
้ก็ถ้าชนะไฟนี้ก็เราจะได้ต่อยกับแองเจล่าลี
Next up, it's the one Atomweight World Grand Prix Championship Final! First up, from India, Ritu, the Indian Tigress, Phogat!
The biggest Indian mixed martial arts star in the world, expected to do the trademark pumping of the guns on the scale here, Ritu Phogat.
52.05 kilos for Ritu Phogat.
There it is, the trademark pumping of the biceps from Ritu Phogat, the wrestler. And what an extraordinary wrestler she is. You've got to ask, how will Stamp stuff the takedowns of Ritu Phogat? Nobody has done it so far.
And now her opponent from Thailand, Stamp.
Beloved with striking fans around the world, the former kickboxing and Muay Thai world champion Stamp from Thailand. And look at the focus in her eyes. Stamp has prepared like a demon for tomorrow.
51.15 kilos for Stamp.
Well, don't know if a little bit of mind games being played there. She didn't want to be outdone in the guns department. Stamp flashing the biceps. And now we see her and Ritu face to face on the stare down. Ritu Phogat not blinking, nor is Stamp. This is going to be extraordinary, Drake. You can cut the atmosphere with a chainsaw on this one.
Yeah, Michael, look at that belt. Look at the World Grand Prix belt. That is a thing of beauty. These two are going to throw down for it.
You know, that belt, Ritu has had a sketch of it on the homepage of her phone for the last 6 months. Every time she wakes up in the morning, she looks at that phone. She's had her goal set on that strap since day one. No one is more focused, Dragon, than Ritu.
Eye on the prize. I love it. I love it. No matchup of striker versus grappler has been more anticipated than the finals of these Atomweight World Grand Prix matchup right here. This is exciting. I cannot wait.
Who chose Ritu to be in the final all those days ago, Dragon?
I will bow to you. You chose Ritu all the way through it, but wow, does she have a tough matchup tomorrow night.
It is going to be tough. Let's go back down to Dom to hear from these two superb athletes.
Ritu, good to see you again. Welcome back to Singapore. The stage has been set. Striker versus grappler. Does it make any difference to you that your opponent knows your strength is wrestling?
Everyone know I'm wrestler, but tomorrow I'm excited for tomorrow, and I will show all the world I am the best in automatic category.
You look so relaxed. You look so happy. Is it going to be magic tomorrow from you, Ritu?
Yeah, because my all Indian sports around the world support me and they give me motivates. Yeah, I'm excited for tomorrow.
We are excited for tomorrow. Thank you very much, Ritu. Ladies and gentlemen, there she is, the Indian Tigress.
She looks like a kid in a candy shop. I've never seen Ritu Phogat that excited, Dragon.
She's calm, she's focused, and she is happy to be here, Michael.
Well, we're going to hear from Stamp in just a moment. Let's go back down to Tom.
So dig up, Stamp. Welcome back to Singapore. It's good to see you. Now listen, Ritu has said on multiple occasions that your grappling skills are no match for her, but I'm pretty sure that you have an answer for that.
ค่ะคุณสแตมยินดีต้อนรับกลับมาที่สิงคโปร์อีกครั้งนะคะยินดีที่ได้เจออีกครั้งหนึ่งคุณลิตูคู่ต่อสู้เนี่ยค่ะเขาพูดตลอดเลยว่า grapple game ของคุณสแตมเนี่ยเทียบเขาไม่ได้อันนี้คิดว่ายังไงบ้างเอ่ย
ก็แน่นอนค่ะแกรปเปอร์เขาเก่งกว่าหนูแน่นอนแต่มวยไทยหนูเก่งกว่าเขาแน่นอนค่ะ
Well she may be better than my grapple game but my Muay Thai is definitely the best
I'm telling you you could not have painted a better matchup for tomorrow night between you and Ritu striker versus grappler it's gonna be lit tomorrow night ladies and gentlemen one more time Stamp
Stamp all smiles as well. And you know, she's right, Dragon. This really is a classic match of styles. Wrestler or Muay Thai fighter, which style will prevail?
You got the two-sport former world champion getting ready to add another belt to her collection, or will Ritu capture her first championship? This is something you do not want to miss, ladies and gentlemen. This is a really fun matchup, and I think it's going to light the mixed martial arts world on fire tomorrow night.
Speaking of fire, and don't forget, there's one lady watching this one closer than anyone else in the world. That is Angela Lee. She is waiting in the wings next year. She will face the winner, either Ritu or Stamp, for the Atomweight World title, in which Angela Lee's never been beaten at Atomweight. Never. Undefeated, untouched, unblemished. Think about that. Okay, the big one, the main event. Regian Eersel says he gets no respect from fans around the world. He's looking to go 18 wins in a row. He wants his respect.
Make some noise up there! Regian Eersel is an assassin. The immortal is unstoppable. The ruthless mix of aggression, speed, and power. No one has been able to figure out the puzzle that is Regian Eersel.
Ik vind het, ik voel me speciaal natuurlijk. Dat ze andere vechters moeten halen buiten de divisie natuurlijk. Ja, ik wil de dominantste vechter zijn in mijn gewichtklasse natuurlijk.
Regian Eersel is een all-out thrashing machine.
Op dit moment niet iemand in de rankings, denk ik, die het verdient, zeg maar, ook tegen mij te komen staan. Dus iemand zoeken van buiten de rankings. Dat is Islam geworden.
Я сразу прохожу и забираю то, что мне принадлежит. Которую я войду и стану чемпионом. К моему стилю вообще невозможно подготовиться. Бью откуда где придется. Важно, я падаю, лечу, лежу, стою. Я бью со всех позиций, поэтому пусть ко всему будет готово.
Ook van hoe hij het zegt, dat iemand zegt dat zijn stijl als een verrassing voor me gaat komen.
Будет мясо, много крови будет. Чемпион я здесь, что еще не пришло, не получалось выйти, показать это. Публику не собираюсь шокировать, я собираюсь его пошокировать.
Zullen we dat zien in de kooi, in de ring? Ja, het liefst wil ik dit gevecht natuurlijk beëindigen door middel van een KO. Ik hoop dat je klaar bent.
Come to the main event for the one lightweight kickboxing world championship. First up, the challenger from Russia, Islam Murtazaev.
You know, one championship scoured the world to find somebody, anybody willing to fight Regian Eersel after Eersel twice defeated Nicky Holsken. Only this man put his hand up.
77.1 kilos for Islam Murtazaev.
77.1 for Murtazaev, who says, I'm already the world champion. This is just my chance to prove it. He's cocky. He's super confident. Can he do it?
And now, please welcome the reigning and defending undisputed one lightweight kickboxing champion of the world from Suriname, Regian the Immortal Eersel.
He's a phenomenon. 18 in a row he is going for tomorrow night, almost unheard of in the combat sports world.
76.7 kilos for Regian Eersel.
Slightly lighter than the challenger is the champion, Regian Eersel. My gosh, you talk about meanness and you talk about the champion. Look at the size of Eersel, the length of the legs. Oh, Murtazaev gets up in Regian's face. He is right in the champion's face, and Eersel is staring through him. Wow! Murtazaev could beat a statue in a staring contest. This is intensity between these two warriors. Oh, Dragon, you can feel this one, man. You can feel it, brother!
There is no bigger prize
Regian's
in all of combat sports.
Look at that!
Look at this.
Regian's still greasing him off.
There is no bigger prize in combat sports than what is strapped around Regian Eersel's shoulders. And now Murtazaev, in his first match in one Super Series, has the opportunity to challenge for it. Can he handle the pressure, Michael?
Regian's looking at him again. Did you see that? Regian went back and stared at him again. You've got to wonder if Murtazaev has done something no one else has done and got inside the head a little of a champion.
I don't think so, Michael. I don't think he got in the head of the Immortal One. The Immortal One knows the task is huge in front of him, but Regian Eersel runs through everybody with that pressure. He melts his opponents. I don't think he's scared, but I think he's ready for the challenge.
Oh my goodness. I've been commentating Regian Eersel for a number of years and talking to him this week. I have never seen the champion this focused and this determined not only to win, but also to knock somebody the hell out, Dragon. And that somebody is Islam Murtazaev. Let's go back down to Tom. This one's going to be crazy.
Champ, it is good to see you again, brother. That was a ferocious face-off right there. But, I mean, I've seen you all week. I've seen you training. You can't wait to get inside that one championship circle, can you?
I can't wait. Tomorrow is going to be war.
It's going to be war. Come on, give us a little bit more than that. What can we expect from you tomorrow?
You can expect fireworks. He says he's going to surprise me. Well, I like surprises, so we'll see tomorrow.
All right, baby. Well, whatever happens tomorrow, it is, as you say, going to be fireworks. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the world title on the line, the one lightweight kickboxing championship. Thank you very much, Regian. We'll see you tomorrow night, sir.
Yes, thank you.
All right.
Man, Regian Eersel is a nasty, nasty guy. I mean, he sends letters, you know, to hypochondriacs, get well letters, just for the fun of it. He's a nasty dragon, and he wants to knock out Murtazaev quickly tomorrow.
Yeah.
Prove a point, get his respect.
Yeah, and I think we're going to see a very high-pressure style coming from both these guys. I asked Eersel, I was like, you know, what is it going to take to beat you? And he says, you need to counter my pressure with pressure of your own. And Murtazaev says he's going to do exactly that. These two are going to walk forward into the center of the circle and throw down.
I think to beat Eersel, you've got to drop a grand piano on him from a great height. Folks, it's going to be a cracker of a card. One Winter Warriors tomorrow night here at the Singapore Indoor Stadium. Double main event, double championship gold in both those fights, and we are on the air everywhere. Broadcast to over 150 countries. I know in India, on Disney Plus, Hotstar, and Star Sports Select One, they will be cheering on Ritu. And in Thailand, on AIS Play and Tyrat 32, they will be cheering on Stamp in the final of the Atomweight World Grand Prix. Folks, from myself, Michael Chiavello, Mitch Chulson, and all the crew here at One, we'll see you tomorrow night for One Winter Warriors.